Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to use scheduled executor service as a timer in Android Studio. So here in activity main.xml, I have a text view inside a linear layout, and for this text view the ID is text view 1. In this text view I will display the current time and I will stop the timer after 20 seconds. Or after 15 seconds. So let's go to main activity. In main activity, in onCreate, I have defined this text view as find view by id r.id.textview1. Now initially for this text view I will set the text to current time. So here I will write set text current time plus new date java.util.date. So this will display the current time in text view 1. After that I will use the schedule at fixed rate feature of scheduled executor service. So first I will define scheduled executor service java.util.concurrent scheduled executor service. I will give it a name, my scheduled executor. My scheduled executor is equal to executors. Here I will write this executors java.util.concurrent dot, and here I will write new schedule thread pool. In this I will set the thread pool to 1. So I have one thread pool in this executor service. Now I will execute this by writing my schedule executor dot schedule at fixed rate. So here I have to first add a runnable, then the initial delay, then the total period of delay, and then the time unit for this initial delay and the period. First I will add a runnable. Here I will write new runnable. So this will automatically add a runnable here. New runnable at override public void run. And inside this, I can write my code. But first I will set the delay. So here, after this, and inside this bracket. So inside this bracket, I will put a comma and set the initial delay to 1 second, comma the fixed rate of delay or the duration of delay to 1 second, comma the time unit that I will set to time unit java.util.concurrent.timeunit.seconds. Okay, now in this runnable, so now it will run after a delay of 1 second. For every 1 second, it will keep running until we stop it. So here I will display the current time in text view. So for that, I will just copy this. Now I have to stop it after 20 seconds. So for that, here I will add a counter, int count is equal to 0, and while it is running I will add 1 to the counter, count plus plus, and here I will write if count is more than 19. Then I will stop this executor. So I will just copy this. My schedule executor dot shutdown. And that's all. Now let's check this. So here you can see this app, and it is currently showing the time in which the second is changing continuously, and it will keep changing for 20 seconds, and after that it stops. So here you can see that it has stopped now. Now let's add this stop button for stopping this timer. So here after this text view, I will add a button. With width match parent and height wrap content and ID. Button 1. Okay, so this is not visible here in this hello world because the height of this text with match pencil will make it wrap content here. Now for this button, I will set the text to stop timer. Okay, now let's go to main activity.java. Here first I will define the button. Button 1 is equal to find view by ID. Button 1. Okay, now for this button 1, I will set an on click listener. Button 1 dot set on click listener, new view dot on click listener at override public void on click. So when this is clicked, I have to shut down the executor. So I'll just copy this and I will remove this if else block here. And here now I do not need this counter, so I will remove this. And here in this button 1 on click, I will shut down the executor. But now it is showing that this executor, it doesn't recognize. So first I have to define it outside. So I will just copy this. I have to declare it outside on click. So I will declare it here. And now here I will define directly the my schedule executor. Okay, now let's check this. Okay, so now it has launched and you can see that it is displaying the current time with the seconds changing continuously. Now when I click on stop timer, the seconds will stop increasing. So that's all in this video. I hope this was useful. Thank you very much for watching this video.